Hello everyone, it's me, Clayson. I just finished watching The Trial of the Chicago 7, directed and written by Aaron Sorkin and starring Eddie Redmayne, Jeremy Strong, Mark Rylance, Michael Keaton, and several other great actors in what's definitely an Oscar-worthy showcase of actors in a fact-based true story about the trial of the Chicago 7. The trial of seven men who were accused of and intentionally starting a massive riot in 1968 and happened to change the course of American history as we know it. But let's get to the story, shall we? The story follows the Chicago Seven and Bobby Seale, who's unofficially the eighth member of this, as they go through their trial and the trial goes through all the events that led up to said trial and the events that took place during it. As the Chicago Seven and Bobby Seale have to deal with a bunch of prejudiced people, a trial that seems built to be against them, a prosecutor who seems nearly impossible to beat, and almost every single thing that they go for to try and win this trial seems to blow up in their faces. Now, when it comes down to the facts about this movie, a lot of them are historically accurate from what I can tell. They take a few liberties here and there, mainly for cinematic sake, but for the most part, it is pretty fact-based, as well as keeping with Aaron Sorkin's directorial style. And by his directorial style, I mean it includes a lot of his witty dialogue and a lot of his emotionally impactful beats, particularly the ones by Eddie Redmayne and Sacha Baron Cohen, who play Abby and Tom, respectively. It's definitely really nice to see that this film, you can tell it was originally meant to be in theaters, but due to the COVID-19 pandemic, it was put over to Netflix and released just today. And you can definitely see that in the production values, as the film faithfully recreates the era of the 1960s, everything from the costume designs to the overall atmosphere to even most of the language chosen for the film. It does manage to create some great parallels with the political things going on in the 60s and to how things are going on right now. Even though there's a big difference between politics in the 60s and politics now, there are similarities that do help the film become rather relevant, even though the film's events took place decades ago, showing us that history can repeat itself in often frightening ways. And a lot of that is brought forward because of the strength of the actors involved. Ed Redmayne, Baron Cohen, Jeremy Strong, and Joseph Gordon-Levitt especially offer a ton of great moments with their acting. And whether they're on the side of the Chicago 7 or whether they're on the prosecution, all of them managed to impress me. Also, the film happens to avoid the trap that a lot of these movies take of just making stuff up for the sake of big impacts in the cinematic world. It doesn't feel like they're just rewriting history for the sake of a shocking moment. It feels very much like they're not only staying true to history, but also trying to portray it in a way that feels authentic. That definitely comes through in the writing and directing from Sorkin, and also because the film generally has a great sense of pacing as well. Despite the film being over 2 hours in length, but that's including the credits, it never at any point feels boring. There's always some impassioned speech or some cutaway to an event previously that always manages to keep things interesting and always manages to keep things engrossing, especially considering the times we live in. If most of the actors in this movie don't get an Oscar nomination at least, I'll be very surprised. And that's why I'm going to give The Trial of the Chicago 7, a film that I consider almost perfect in most ways, a 9 out of 10. See you next time.